Interlune, a secretive startup focused on in-space resource mining, has secured $15.6 million in funding, with an additional $2.1 million being sought, according to a recent SEC filing. This marks the first public disclosure of funding for the company since its $1.85 million seed round in 2022. Based in Seattle, Interlune was founded by industry veterans, including Rob Mason, who previously served as president of Blue Origin, alongside Gary Lai, Blue Origin's former chief architect, and Indra Hornsby, ex-VP of Rocket Lab. Established in 2020, Interlune has maintained a low profile until now. The company's aim is not only to harness lunar resources, but also to sell high-value resources here on Earth. On their website, they state, "As the first company to commercialize resources in space, Interlune will unlock unprecedented growth and innovation for the betterment of Earth and humankind." Not much is known about the company, but the CTO, Gary Lai, did give a speech at Seattle's Museum of Flight, where he briefly mentioned Interlune. He said, "We aim to be the first company that harvests natural resources from the moon to use here on Earth. We're building a completely novel approach to extract those resources efficiently, cost-effectively, and also responsibly. The goal is really to create a sustainable in-space economy. Earth's future is in our orbit," Interlune's website proclaims. Lai said the opportunities for ventures such as Interlune are being made possible because of the work that companies like Blue and others are doing, funded by the Artemis program to create an infrastructure for space transportation. While details on the venture are difficult to find, the company's website describes the startup as harvesting natural resources from space to benefit Earth and establish an in-space economy. Helium 3, the most valuable resource in space. If the moon's surface was littered with pure diamonds, it still wouldn't be financially viable to return them to Earth. There is, however, one resource that is so valuable and rare that it does make sense to mine it on the moon and sell it back on Earth. And that resource is Helium 3. Now, some people may be rolling their eyes and saying, sure, Helium 3, for nuclear fusion reactors that don't exist and won't for decades. Mining Helium 3 on the moon does not seem like it would be profitable. Most people would be highly skeptical, including their co-founder and CTO, Gary Lai. He said, "Then I started doing engineering analysis and we started talking to customers. It took probably 6 months before I realized this was a real thing and something that no serious organization was going after." Did you know that after 9/11, the Department of Homeland Security mandated the use of Helium 3 for radiation portal monitors at US border crossings? Here is a chart showing the decline in US Helium 3 stockpiles after that mandate. This resulted in a shortage of Helium 3 that has never been solved. Interlune has found some other interesting and non-nuclear related use cases for Helium 3. In a September 2024 blog post, Gary Lai provided more details of their Helium 3 mining plan. They will use a robotic harvester to automate the process of mining and processing the lunar regolith. They aim to begin supplying Helium 3 to markets on Earth in the 2030s. Interlune gives four uses of Helium 3. I list them here with a few remarks for each practical use case. For quantum computing, Helium 3 is crucial for cooling quantum computers to near absolute zero temperatures, where the quantum bits can operate without thermal interference. This could significantly boost the development and efficiency of quantum computing technologies. In the medical field, Helium 3 can be used in lung MRI scans, providing clearer images than traditional methods, potentially revolutionizing diagnostic imaging for respiratory conditions. Its unique properties also make it an excellent coolant for various cryogenic applications, enhancing the performance of superconducting magnets and other high-tech equipment that requires extremely low temperatures. These applications highlight Helium 3's value beyond its traditional nuclear fusion potential, suggesting a broader market for the isotope once it becomes available in larger quantities from lunar mining operations. According to Lai, the quantum market was the critical piece of the business case. If you had Helium 3 today, the customers would buy it at $20 million a kilo in quantities large enough to make a profit. In the early days, Interlune is expecting to return up to 20 kilos of Helium 3, so the revenue for quantum applications could be up to $400 million. This small amount won't alter market prices. Demand is going up as quantum computing companies are growing rapidly. Okay, Now we understand the importance of Helium 3 in Interlune's business case for mining the moon. Let's look at their Lunar Harvester in more detail. Interlune's Lunar Harvester is designed to be smaller, lighter, and more energy efficient than other concepts in the industry, which significantly reduces the cost of transporting it to the moon and operating it there. With the recent influx of funds from investors, Interlune is moving forward with the design of its first robotic lander mission. This mission aims to validate the concentration of resources at the site chosen for their initial mining operations. Currently, Interlune's primary focus is on extracting helium-3, but the company has plans to expand its operations to include other valuable resources, like industrial metals, rare earth elements, and water. This expansion will support a sustained human presence on the moon and contribute to a thriving space economy. The company's small team of about 20 employees is diligently working on developing the hardware necessary for mining and processing lunar soil. They are addressing numerous challenges, including how to manage the release of solar wind volatiles, handle the electrostatic, sticky, and abrasive nature of lunar regolith, and the technical difficulty of isolating the helium-3 isotope from other elements. Today, we're building subscale models of excavator concepts and testing them with regolith simulants to measure power consumption and performance. We'll build full-scale prototypes later in 2024. Interlune's helium-3 harvester will employ advanced technology, including vision sensors and ground-penetrating radar, to map out the most efficient path for harvesting. A robotic arm on the harvester will clear away large surface rocks that cannot be processed. If the machine encounters obstacles too big to move or buried beneath the surface, it will either change its route or temporarily halt operations. Okay, let's look at milestones next. Interlune is a stealthy company, so we don't have many milestones to report on yet. The National Science Foundation has awarded funding to Interlune for developing a key technology in lunar in-situ resource utilization, or ISRU for short. This technology focuses on efficiently sorting lunar regolith by particle size, which is crucial for various processing applications like extracting oxygen, creating construction materials, and supporting 3D printing on the moon. Interlune's project aims to create a compact, low-mass sorting system that is far more efficient than traditional methods like vibratory sieves. They plan to develop a new lunar regolith simulant to test this technology, examining how size sorting behaves in the moon's low gravity. The sorting method involves a centrifuge with rotating paddles, where experiments will optimize designs for better throughput and prevent sieve blockages. The technology's effectiveness will be tested under simulated lunar gravity conditions on a parabolic flight. This initiative could tap into a multi-billion dollar market by enabling missions to use local resources, promoting the concept of living off the land on the moon. In July 2024, Interlune was awarded a grant from NASA's Tech Flights program to develop and test its technology for processing lunar soil. This technology, known as beneficiation, enhances the soil's properties to allow the extraction of valuable resources like helium-3. This initiative supports various lunar activities, including construction and life support. Interlune plans to commercialize these lunar resources, targeting markets in quantum computing, security, medical imaging, and fusion energy. In October 2024, Interlune receives US Department of Energy grant to increase the supply of domestic helium-3. Interlune was awarded a $365,000 grant by the US Department of Energy to develop technology for separating helium-3 from existing helium supplies without needing additional tritium production. This initiative focuses on using the magnetocaloric effect to cool helium for separation, which is both energy efficient and cost effective. The project supports the Department of Energy's goal of enhancing domestic isotope supply chains, crucial for applications like quantum computing, which demands extremely low temperatures for operation. Currently, tritium decay is the only meaningful source of helium-3 production on Earth, and it is not scalable enough to meet rising demand. While extremely scarce on Earth, helium-3 is plentiful on the Moon. This grant from the DOE Isotope Program provides Interlune with the opportunity to increase the helium-3 supply in the short term while advancing technology to harvest the abundant helium-3 on the Moon soon after, said Rob Mason, Interlune co-founder and CEO. We're delighted to support the Department of Energy's efforts to strengthen our domestic supply chain and further advance US technology leadership. Okay, let's move on to upcoming events. Interlune is currently working on its NSF and Department of Energy projects, so we may hear about the results when the work is completed. In a blog post on their website, they mentioned a 2027 mission. This mission will focus on validating the concentration of helium-3 and other solar wind volatiles at a potential future harvesting site, evaluating the site for operations, and demonstrating Interlune's proprietary extraction technology in the lunar environment. Interlune is currently designing this mission, evaluating commercial landers, and entertaining research collaborations. In 2029, Interlune has plans to establish a lunar pilot plant to prove out every step, including returning meaningful quantities of helium-3 to our customers for a fraction of the launch mass and cost. We'll keep an eye on the lunar and in-space mining operation in the future. Interlune's business case seems to hinge on helium-3 mining. This is a niche resource, but if nuclear reactors were to become more common, demand for helium-3 could skyrocket, leading to a market size in the billions or even tens of billions. For neutron detectors and medical imaging, the market is in the millions or low billions. Be sure to subscribe to get the latest news on commercial space startups around the globe. From rocket launches to space stations, orbital tugs, lunar landers and more, if it's a commercial space startup, we cover it. See you soon.